In this video, we will explain why strong consideration should always be given to replacing air conditioning hoses when replacing the compressor following catastrophic failure or any other major air conditioning repairs. Undetected hose leaks are often the root cause of original compressor failure and subsequent repeat failures. Compressor replacement is one of the most comeback-prone air conditioning repairs. This is usually because the root cause of the original failure is not identified during the initial diagnosis. A common root cause of original compressor failure and subsequent repeat failures on the same vehicle is low refrigerant charge. By the time the typical vehicle comes in a repair shop with a failed compressor, the air conditioning hoses will have been subjected to thousands of underhood heat cycles. In addition, the suction and discharge hoses are subjected to repeat stressing as the engine torques back and forth under acceleration and deceleration. Hoses are composed of a series of custom layers of organic rubber compounds and reinforcement braid. As it ages, it hardens, shrinks, and crystallizes. This deterioration can result in micro leaks at hose crimps. Since PAG oil does not dissolve in R134a, there is usually no telltale oil stain at the point of the leak. Micro leaks that result in a low charge over time can be difficult to find with either dye or electronic leak detection methods. Yet small leaks that result in a low charge over weeks or months can mean death for the compressor. Let's understand how this can happen. If the system develops an undercharge due to a leak, the oil, which does not evaporate, separates from the gaseous refrigerant and drops to the bottom of the evaporator. Now, only pure refrigerant, which by itself is a powerful degreaser, returns to the compressor. This washes down the vital lubricating film of oil from the compressor moving parts. With no lubrication, the compressor starts to wear and fails rapidly. And so you can see how an undetected leak is often the root cause of a repeat compressor failure months after the original repair. In fact, a smaller leak can be more damaging to the compressor than a large leak because the compressor is slowly starved of lubrication over a longer period of time until it finally fails. So, with the understanding that a small, hard-to-find hose leak may in fact be the root cause of many original and repeat compressor failures, let's consider several other reasons why it is a good idea to replace air conditioning hoses as a matter of course during a compressor replacement job. If a vehicle comes in with an obvious large leak or catastrophically failed compressor, you probably won't be able to pressurize and leak check the system until after the compressor has been replaced and the system is operational. Since every inch of the refrigerant path should be either new or flushed before replacing the compressor, this means that if you have not replaced the hoses, you may be spending valuable time and expensive flush solvent flushing hoses that you may find later are actually leaking. By replacing the hoses, you will eliminate an area of uncertainty from the beginning. If you find a leak later, after the system has been recharged, you will have to recover the system, remove and replace the leaking hose, recharge the system, and leak check it again. It would almost certainly have been easier and more cost-effective to replace the hose when it was disconnected at both ends instead of flushing it. In many cases, the cost of labor to perform the flush and the cost of a quality flush solvent may exceed the cost of a new hose. Remember, you are not just eliminating the inconvenience of finding a leak immediately when the repair is complete, but the much greater cost and inconvenience of a catastrophically failed compressor weeks or perhaps months later due to a lack of lubrication from a low refrigerant charge. Also, fine microscopic abrasive particulates from the failed compressor may be embedded in the interior barrier of the hose lining. These abrasive particles may not be readily removed by normal flushing. Instead, they are released back into the system over time as high-pressure refrigerant courses through the hose. Then, of course, they find their way back to the compressor, leading to yet another failure. Many hoses also have filters or muffers in the line that make them impossible to flush. Debris clogs the filter, as you can see here, or becomes trapped in the muffler and cannot be flushed out. As you can see, the only pathway for refrigerant through this muffler is through a few tiny pinholes. In conclusion, consider replacing the hose assembly as an integral part of any compressor replacement job. the saving in time, flush, and labor, plus the increased confidence in the immediate outcome and the longevity of the job is well worth it.